So this morning, we actually were invited to participate in a think tank here in Wausau County with Dr. Susan Madsen. And if you don't know who she is, please go look her up. We've been following her for years. We've invited her to events, and we love all the research and stuff that she contributes to.
She's brilliant. Yeah.
We were one of two of 30 women in that room this morning. So we learned some very staggering stats today on women.
Yeah, and those are things that I would not have known had I have not been sitting in that room. And it's wild, the things that we are learning. So
Utah is ranked among five places that women should not spend their travel dollars, among countries that even kill women. So there are countries, I think, what were some of the countries she mentioned that rank in these five places?
Yeah, I can't remember the other ones.
Like
Afghanistan.
Yeah, yeah. Where they kill women. Yeah. And then Utah is
Utah was one of those five. So these are stats that they've taken. They've done a lot of studies. They've done a lot of research. She had all of the organizations up there. But ultimately, Utah is the worst state for women equality. The worst. We are the bottom of the line.
Yep. We are the second most sexist state in the country. And actually, that one doesn't actually surprise me as much.
No, it's wild.
Right.
Let's see, talked about, there was a time when we were just 7 points. They put these on points, that we were just 7 points behind Idaho as being the worst state. Then years passed, then we were 12 points behind them. Now Idaho has passed, and now we're 22 points behind the next closest person. So while these other states are making changes, Utah, we're just staying stagnant, and we are not really going in the right direction.
One of the things that she said that like really hit me is, on our current trajectory of moving the needle for women and things like that, we are 3 to 4 decades before we are making progress. How sad is that?
Decades.
You guys, we have daughters.
Yeah.
We have daughters.
And so they're going to be our age, and that's when they're finally maybe going to see progress. Heartbreaking. We got to do better than this. I thought that the statistics on the number of women who would be sexually assaulted and kids who would be sexually assaulted in the state of Utah are significant. So
it's
women
horrible.
Was
1 in 6.
1 in 6. And kids, you guys, 1 in 7.
Yeah.
1 in 7 kids will be sexually assaulted in the state of Utah. We can do better than that.
We can do better. We are 49th of 50 states in women's preventative care. So like mammograms and things like that to help women's health.
Yeah. So the high school, they did some studies on asking these kids as well. I just wanted to point that one back out. And they said that 1 in 5 high school students in the past 12 months. So this isn't just something that's happening in the past. It's happening now that they're having issues on. Yeah, and we are at the bottom. We don't take care of ourselves. We take care of our family and all of our kids and everyone else, but we forget to take care of ourselves.
Yeah, isn't that weird? One of the other things?
One category that we were the highest in as far as medicine was cosmetic surgery.
There you go.
We also ranked very high on eating disorders. So we are not taking care of ourselves in Utah.
No. One of the other things that was, she used the term childcare desert, and she brought up Wayne County, which is where Marianne's from, and that there literally is, what'd she say, one licensed childcare provider in the whole county.
And we see that here in Wasatch County. We don't have enough childcare.
Right.
Or enough businesses that will support women in bringing their children or working hybrid. So those are some things that have definitely got to change. And not just women, but men. We've got to change that where it's not just the one parent's responsibility.
Yeah. One of the interesting things that they also talked about were the students in the school and like STEM and those kind of classes.
Yeah. This was wild. They said that by the time they get to the 8th grade level, girls are 50% behind boys in math.
Yeah.
50%.
So I think we need to be at a much younger age encouraging those STEM classes
and making them attainable for the girls to be involved as well. That's something that I was definitely not aware of with our school system
either.
To realize that the girls at 8th grade are that much behind the boys.
That's crazy. And they've been in the same classes their whole school career.
And I also loved what she pointed out, because a lot of people might say, oh, it's gender, or it's, you know, it's family, or it's
genetics.
But she said that there are other states where they are equal. Mm-hmm. So you know it's not genetics. It's the way our kids are being encouraged and raised and taught in the school system from a young age. So again,
It's crazy. So obviously, if you guys don't know this yet, we are actually very passionate about women and particularly women in business. We actually have a Women's Business Alliance here locally that we founded 7-8 years ago. Mm-hmm. Because for us, we were women in business with small children, and we didn't have even just the resources mm-hmm. of other people that would like us.
Role models.
Yeah. So with this, we're kind of excited to maybe take some of this information with our Women's Business Alliance, but mm-hmm. we kind of took an actionable item out of today that we know that we can help with.
Yeah, and we are going to bring this down to the girls. So we are going to start a group for younger age, high school, possibly middle school aged girls to be able to get involved and learn about what we can do, because one of the other stats was that Utah is number 50 in the pay gap.
50.
We are at the very bottom. So for the exact same job, women in Utah are getting paid less. So
yeah, so we want to empower girls
to know the
women,
work.
High schoolers, to be able to have the information to make these decisions as they're going out into the workforce or making those decisions in schooling and what they're going to do. And so we're really excited that this will kind of be a spinoff of our Women's Business Alliance. Like we said, it's new. We literally walked away from this morning with an actionable item that we know we can help with. Mm-hmm. And I actually presented it at a meeting I was just at, and we're going to get some connections there. So for anyone that wants to join in and help us out, and you know, if you have daughters, let's empower our little ladies.
Yeah, let us know.
Yeah, let us know if you want to participate or if you can help, or you know, because we want to help too.
Yeah, definitely check out Susan Madsen. You guys go look at the stats yourself. They are staggering. There's so many more things that I could read off here, but I was shocked today.
It was shocking.
Shocking to know that that's where we're at, and Wasatch County is no different. So we can do better.
We can. Okay, thanks for listening.